Hey everyone, and welcome to this visual explanation of the merge sort algorithm. During the explanation, the algorithm will be animated, and the lines of code that are being executed will be highlighted on the right. As its name suggests, merge sort relies on a merge operation. This merge operation is used to merge two already sorted lists together into one big new sorted list. Let's take a look at how this is done. We call the merge function on the left and right sorted lists. Then we initialize an index I and an index j, which start at the beginning of the corresponding lists. Then, as long as neither I or j has reached the end of the list, we compare the values that I and j are pointing at, and we insert the smallest number. In this case, we compare 0 and 2. 0 is the smallest number, so we insert it first. After inserting the number that I was pointing at, we shift I to the right. We are now done with the first iteration, which we repeat until both I and j have reached the end of the list. Let's go over one more example. I is now pointing at 1 and j is pointing at 2. 1 is smaller, so we insert 1 into the list first. After inserting, we shift I to the right. Let's now speed up the animation until either I or j has reached the end of the list. As you can see, there are now no more elements for j to point at. So for our next iterations, we don't need to consider j. We check the condition for the next iteration and see that we have to continue because I has not yet reached the end of the list. So we insert the number that I is pointing at. After inserting the number, we move I to the right. We keep inserting numbers until the list I is pointing at is also empty. Now that we know how to merge two sorted lists into a larger list that is still sorted, let's take a look at the entire merge sort algorithm. We start by calling merge sort on the entire list. Then, because our list has more than one item in it, we say that we want to take the left side of the list and call merge sort on that side. As you may notice, this is where merge sort makes use of recursion. Because inside the function merge sort, we now use merge sort but on the left side of the entire list. So when we do this, we don't go to the next line in our code on the right and merge sort the right, but we jump back to the top of our merge sort function to perform the merge sort for the left side that we just separated. So let's continue. The left side also has more than one item in it. So it takes its left side and calls merge sort on that. This list still has more than one item in it. So once again, we take its left side and call merge sort on it. Now our list does have one item in it, and a list with one item is already sorted. So we are done with this list and we return this list. Because we return something from a left child, we now jump to line 4 because we are ready to do the right side. So we now take the right side and call merge sort on the right side of the list. This list also has one item in it, so we're done sorting it. Now that we have two sorted lists, we can perform the merge that we saw previously to merge two sorted lists. We set I and j to the first elements of both the list. We compare the numbers they are pointing at and see that 0 is smaller than 9. So we insert 0 first. Then we insert the 9 because it's the only number left. As a result of the merge, we now have another sorted list. So it is time to take the right side of its parent and sort that now. This list is larger than 1, so we take the left side and call merge sort on it. The list with the single 8 in it is of size 1. So it is already sorted. And after returning, we call merge sort on the right side. This side still has more than one number in it, so we call merge sort on its left side and determine that it's sorted. Do the same for the right side and also determine that it's sorted. Now that we have a left and right side that are sorted again, we call merge. We insert the 1 first because it is smaller, and then we insert the 5. We now once again have a left and a right side that are sorted. The list with the 8 in it, and the list with the 1 and the 5 in it. So, since the left and the right side are done, we merge them together. We compare the 1 and the 8 and insert the 1. We move the j to the right. We compare the 8 and the 5 and insert the 5. J disappears. Only 8 is left, so we insert the 8. Let's now fast forward the animation until the left side is entirely sorted. Now that it is sorted, we are finally back to our original call of merge sort. And now that we do know the left side, we call merge sort on the right side. And the process repeats again. Thank you for watching. I really hope this video helped you understand the merge sort algorithm. If it did, please leave a like. And if you want to see more content like this, consider subscribing. Have a nice day. Peace.